The 28th Winter Universiade continues here in Almaty, Kazakhstan. There you get some beautiful vistas that surround this city in Kazakhstan. Today in the highlights, we'll go to snowboard. It's the women's and men's slope style. We have speed skating, the men's team pursuit, along with the women. In short track speed skating, it'll be the women's and men's 1500 meters. Nordic combined continues with the Team Gunderson. Ski jumping, the women's team event. And in hockey, men's quarterfinal actions, the Czech Republic and Slovakia. We head up to Shymbaluk for snowboard slope style. A chilly day here in Almaty, but clear. As the athletes get ready, both women and men, first up, there you see Anastasia Loginova. Loginova attends the Ekaterinburg Institute of Physical Education in Russia. Now getting ready for her second jump. You can see she's just thrilled by what she achieved there. 70.50. Now Amber Arazny of Australia. She was the Aussie flag bearer at the opening ceremony. Also just missed out on qualifying for the Sochi Olympics. Competed in Grenada in 2015, finishing eighth. And has been in the snowboard cross here in Almaty already, finishing 17th. Really good run for her, 75 she scores. Next up, Katarzyna Rusin. Rusin of Poland was sixth in the half pipe back in Grenada in 2015. And has competed on the World Cup for both half pipe and slope style. And a really good run for Roos. And there you get a replay of the air these athletes get as they disappear over the crest of that hill. 82.25, and she is pretty pumped about that score. And she should be, because that'll give her a gold medal. Katarzyna Rusin in slope style will win the gold. Amber Arazny of Australia there on the left, she will win silver, and Anastasia Loginova will win the bronze. Now to the men, first up, this is Martin Mikiska. He's of the Czech Republic. He is the defending bronze medalist in this event and was also eighth in the half pipe back in Grenada in 2015. Huge air for him there. And again, on his second aerial, 87.75 for Mikiska, currently in second spot. Now, Aleksi Partanen of Finland. He's been on the World Cup circuit and was 17th last year in the Finnish National Championships. And he temporarily at least moves into top spot. Next up, Mikhail Matveyev of Russia. Third at a recent Europa Cup event in Austria, and he was fourth at Universiade in Spain in 2015. Huge air there for the Russian. And again, as it says on his board, and there you see in slow motion the work that he's doing over the crest of the hill, and huge effort here for Matveyev. 94.50, he'll move ahead of Partanen into top spot, and he would stay there. Gold medal, Mikhail Matveyev of Russia. Silver to Aleksi Partanen of Finland, and Martin Mikiska of the Czech Republic wins the bronze in the men's snowboard slope style. We head up now to the Medeu Sports Complex, a little bit outside of Almaty. for speed skating. This is the women's and men's team pursuit finals. And there you get a look just outside the venue. Really good crowd on hand, despite the chilly temperatures. Temperatures in around minus 15 degrees or so today. First up on the women's side, this is the B final, Japan and Italy. The four skaters that have represented Japan here, Ai Furusho, Nene Sakai, Nana Takahashi, and Mai Yamada. And for Italy, it's Linda Bortolotti, Giulia Lollobrigida, and Gloria Malfatti. Here you see a little bit later in the race, Japan separated out a little bit here. But they will cross first and win the B final, and that will give them the bronze medal. Italy, 1.47 seconds back. Now the A final. This is Russia and Korea. Korea's four skaters that have participated, Jun Ye-jin, Lim Jung-soo, Nam Ji-yoon, and Park Chowan. For Russia, Olesya Chernega, Elena Sokoryakova, Anastasia Zdrakova, and Anastasia Zueva. There you see with four laps to go. Russia a little bit behind the Koreans. And as Korea comes up on the finish line, they will separate out here and push. And Korea will win the gold medal in the women's team pursuit. Russia comes in just under 5 seconds back to win the silver. And there you see the final results. Korea gold, Russia silver, Japan the bronze. Now to the men's side. The Netherlands up against China here in the B final. Gerwin Collier, Olaf Gerritsen, Ronald Lichtenberg, and Jacob Vroedenal for the Netherlands. Dijsselter Tersonigen for China, along with Wang Shiwei and Zhu Zheyao. Six laps to go. China a little bit behind the Dutch. And there you see the Dutch clad in the traditional orange. And this speed skating powerful nation will cross to win the B final and the bronze medal. China, 2 seconds back, will finish fourth. And there you see the Chinese. Good race for them, but not enough to win a medal. Now the A final, Japan up against Korea. For Korea, Lee Jin-young, Moon Hyun-woong, and Oh Hyun-min. For Japan, it's Saitaro Ichinoue, Junwa Miwa, and Showa Agawa. And there you see Korea, just a little bit ahead of Japan right now. Of course, the women already won the gold medal. Men trying to do the same. And here they come to the finish line. Korea will win both pursuit finals. Japan here will take the silver for the men, and the Netherlands will win the bronze in the men's team pursuit. From the Balawan Sholak Short Track Arena. Short track speed skating gets underway here at Universiade. Crowd excited to see this. First up, this will be the women's final. Kim A. Lang of Korea. She won a gold medal in the 3,000 meter relay at the Sochi Olympics and is the defending Universiade gold medalist. She's in helmet number 20. No Do-hee of Korea also in this. She's wearing helmet 21, a two-time overall world junior champion. Sun Ha-kyung of Korea also here, helmet 22. She won a bronze at Granada in the 1,000 meters. In front right now though, briefly there was Zhang Yizhe of China. won a silver in Osaka in 2015 at the Short Track World Junior Championships. Now with three laps to go, there you see in front, that's Kim A. Lang. But Zhang takes over the lead yet again. And a great move on the inside there by Sun Ha Kyung. She's now in front. Oh, and there's a bump and two skaters go out. Zhang being one of them. And Sun Ha Kyung with that great move will take the gold medal. Kim A. Lang will take silver and Moemi Kikuchi of Japan will win the bronze. And there you see Sun as she receives her gold medal. So Korea 1-2 in the women's 1500 meters here at Short Track. Now to the men's side. There you see the start list for the 1500 meters. This event has been absolutely dominated by the Koreans. Since 2001, they have only failed once to win both gold and silver, and that was in 2003 when Marc-André Monette of Canada won a silver medal. And since 2001, of the 24 medals, gold, silver, and bronze that have been given out, Korea has won 20 of them. So it has been absolute domination by the Koreans. But here right now in top spot is Xiao Shui. He's in helmet 37, but he gets past there. And that's Park Ji-won now in front. He's wearing helmet number 60. A little bit of jostling going on. Park, though, still comfortable in top spot. We come now two laps to go. And a little more pushing, but there's a fall. Lim Kyung-won of Korea goes down. And right now it's Park and Kim, both of Korea. And the streak continues. Again, Korea goes 1-2 in the men's 1500 meters. Park Ji-won wins the gold. Kim Do-kyum will take silver, and Nurburgen Zumagaziev of Kazakhstan will win the bronze medal. The domination by the Koreans continues here as short track speed skating begins in Almaty. There you see the Sunkar International Ski Jumping Complex, site today in Nordic Combined of the men's Team Gunderson Normal Hill competition. We followed by the 3x5 kilometer cross country race. First up, we'll take a look at Japan in the ski jumping portion. And a really good jump, good telemark landing there. And for Go Yamamoto, he's okay with it, 100 meters on that jump. He would score 131.3 points. So you hear that great sound through the air as they come flying down. Another solid jump, this time David Velda, 95 meters, 120.7 points for him. Adam Chiesler, he has dominated Nordic Combined at Universiade over the last few years. Already has a silver medal from the individual Gunderson here, and he won that event in 2013 and 2015. And he also added a gold in the mass start here earlier at Universiade. 95 meters, 118.8 points for him and Team Poland. Now Vyacheslav Barkov. Barkov was the gold medal winner in the individual Gunderson. then he will fly down. You see the speed, 89 kilometers an hour. And for Barkov, 95 meters, 120.9 points. So that will set things up. There you see the standings. And on the far right, the times from which each team will enter the ski race behind Japan. So Japan will start off first. Russia will start off 5 seconds after, Germany 11 seconds after, and then Poland 20 seconds behind them. So there you see the teams out and on the course. It's a 2.5 kilometer course. They'll each do 2 laps. And again, it is a relay, so a total of 3 skiers, each doing 5 kilometers. There you see Shota Horigome of Japan, the first skier out for them. Followed there by Wojciech Maruszarz of Poland. Now there's the handoff. And now Yamamoto, there you see him for Japan. And right behind and now moving ahead is Adam Chiesler. And Chiesler now taking control of this race. You see him powering through the spectator area. And he will hand off to Pavel Slowiak. Slowiak won a bronze in the individual Gunderson. And there you get a look at the Russian skier, Barkov. And there is Slowiak working his way up one of the hills here on this 2,500 meter course. And Slowiak and Team Poland, you can see there comfortably in front and stylishly across the finish line in a time of 37 minutes, 27.9 seconds. Coming up in second place, there you see Barkov. He will add a silver medal to the gold that he earned in the individual Gunderson. His teammates over to congratulate him. And the strongest ski jumpers in the competition, the Japanese, are able to do enough on the ski course today to finish in third spot, a little over a minute back of Poland. So there you have the Polish trio, Maruszarz, Chiesler, and Slowiak. Gold medal winners, and there you see the times. Germany in fourth spot. Poland atop the podium in the men's Team Gunderson here in Almaty. From the Sunkar International Ski Jumping Complex, this is the Women's Normal Hill Team Competition. Clear skies here for this afternoon of jumping. Good crowds on hand as the athletes get ready to fly. First up, this is Stefania Nadimova of Russia. This is her second jump. And a good jump for her. Lost the ski a little bit on the landing, but her total will be 195.8 for the 2 jumps. Now Karolina Indrashkova of the Czech Republic. She was 8th in the women's normal hill individual competition earlier at Universiad. Good landing for her on her second jump. Her overall total 146.4, 75 and a half meters on that attempt. Now Yuka Kobayashi of Japan. She was the silver medalist in the normal hill individual competition and a bronze medalist in the mixed team competition. So Japan definitely the favorites here. A little bit of a stutter on the landing. You can see there, even by her reaction, she knew that she had to fight to hold that one. Her overall total, 211.5. Now here is Marta Kropelková of the Czech Republic. She was a medalist in the Normal Hill competition as well, winning bronze, and then took a silver in the mixed team event. A good jump for her. Her total 198, that last jump 87.5 meters. Now Elena Sutyugina, she's of Russia, finished 10th in the Normal Hill competition. Good jump for her, decent landing, 112 total points. Now Haruka Iwasa. Two gold already here at Universiade, seeking her third. She won the gold in the Normal Hill competition, as well as in the mixed team competition. And you can see why. She outpaces everybody here. Haruka Iwasa, 94 meters, 221.3 points. And there you see Iwasa and Kobayashi. They will win the gold medal. And there the teams congratulate each other. Japan easily winning gold, 432.8 points. The Czech Republic in the silver medal spot, and Russia will win the bronze medal. Iwasa about to collect her third gold here in Almaty. And there you have it, the women's team Normal Hill competition at Universiade. There you have a look outside the Holik Arena here in Almaty. This is the men's quarterfinal, the third quarterfinal. Canada and Russia each won theirs yesterday. Czech Republic here taking on Slovakia. The winner will get the winner of the next quarterfinal between Kazakhstan and Sweden. There you see Martin Unak and Dominik Steiner, both team captains. Andrej Vibo, head coach of Team Slovakia. And we're underway here at Holik. And the Czechs would control things in the early going. Shot fired in there, but a relatively easy stop by Peter Putec. Ballner with the attempt. Another turnover at the blue line by Slovakia. Shot there, rebound spilled by Putec. And Novak will collect the rebound and slide it around Peter Putec. And the Czech Republic at the 405 mark, up by one. And there you see the rebound not controlled by Putec. And shortly after, another turnover by the Slovaks, and it results in a goal there for Jan Muller. Great pass from David Ballner as Pichnarczyk tried to kick it out of the zone. Couldn't do it, and it results in the second goal 32 seconds after the first. The Czechs are up by two. Now, late in the first period, Slovakia scrambling around the front of the Czech net on the power play, but they can't cash in. Brazdil finally able to spot it as it goes safely behind the net. So after the first period, 2-0, the Czechs leading Slovakia. Into the second period, the Czechs on the power play. Hot shot there, but Peter Putec with a nice glove stop and a little bit of pushing and shoving after the whistle. Now midway through the second period, puck will squirt back to Jan Žloka, and he rifles a wrister over the shoulder of Brazdil, and Slovakia cuts the lead in half. You'll see it there, just bounce around. and Zloka wastes no time. Perfect shot, top shelf. 2-1, the check's now up. And shortly after that, Slovakia with a chance to tie. Jakubik slides past the goal line. Otherwise, he might have had a tap-in. The give and go, and Piacha gave it back to him, but Jakubik was behind the line. Now Zocker with a good individual effort. Backhand stop there by Putec. Zocker was dangerous all night for the Czech Republic. Now late in the second, Slovakia on the power play. They'll break out 2-on-1. Unak, Pichnarczyk. But he cannot cash in, and a penalty behind the play against Slovakia. But there you see the chance. Just could not tip it home. And a late flurry by Slovakia almost results in the tying goal here in the second. But we'll head to the third period with Slovakia down by one. In the third, though, a beautiful toe drag there by Peter Gappa. You'll get a great look at it right here as he pulls it around Marek Kaluza, and we're tied at two. But the Czechs would come right back. David Zakar. Good effort here, and you'll see it goes off the stick of Jakubik, and he beats his own goaltender. Tough break there for Slovakia, but they would come right back. 40 seconds later, Tomáš Hluk will fire that one behind Brazdil, who lost sight of it, and suddenly we're tied at three. Overtime would solve nothing. So we head to a shootout. Both teams would score on their first two chances, but Edmund Piatchka is stopped there by Brazdil. Zakar almost loses it, and then it goes off the pad and past Putec. Now Jakubik, he's stopped by Brazdil. Other way, Muller can end it here. No, great save by Peter Putec to give Slovakia one last chance. Zloka cannot beat Brazdil. And the Czech Republic, despite the comeback from Slovakia, win. They will head to the semifinal against either Kazakhstan or Sweden.